Alright everyone, welcome back to Let's Play Kingdom Hearts Birth by Sleep, Terra's Route. And we are going to go ahead and resume and land on the Olympus Coliseum.
Stay back.
So I'm guessing this is before Ventus. Okay, one of the really cool features of this game is the timeline that you can see after you beat the entire story of one person. It's really useful in figuring out who went where first or last or whatever. Messed up. So I find it interesting that, I mean, of course they won. That's just how this story would unfold. That's obvious. But I do find it interesting that Terra seems to have been, despite them going in the same order, even the way the worlds are presented, they go in the same order. They arrive at different times. Sometimes Aqua's first, sometimes Ventus, sometimes Terra, and there doesn't really seem to be a rhyme or reason. So I'm wondering if when that people jump into a world, there's a level of arbitrary time in which you're dropped into a certain specific time portion of that world's story. In which case, I don't know, it's just an interesting idea, I think.
Thunder!
Shit. I'm wondering if each world has like a set story that it just kind of plays over and over again. And so sometimes when you go to a world, you end up at different portions of the storyline. Or can you control it? Is there a way to control it? There we go. Is there a way to control at what time in the story you pop into a world? From the front. It's just so fucking annoying.
You okay? Huh? Yeah, thanks. Guess they were too much for me. I'm just gonna have to train harder. You're pretty tough. You really handle those things. Are you here to enter the games?
What games?
The games. To see who's strongest. One day, I'm gonna win them all and become a true hero.
Hurt! Where are you? Front and center right now, or I'm tacking on another 1,000 laps.
Uh-oh. Gotta go. The Coliseum's just up ahead. I hope I get to see you fight there sometime!
A competition. I should find out how strong I really am.
Hmm.
so sorry, you guys. I left the commentary on, and you probably heard some overlap. I'm just now realizing that. I'm so sorry. So, I don't know how I feel about Terra so much. I genuinely like Ventus, and I don't really care for Aqua, but Terra is in this weird state of where I'm like, I don't really know how I feel about him as a character.
Jeez Louise, one chump after another. Like a who's who of decathlon disasters around here. All I need is one measly warrior tough enough to give Zeus a jolt of his own medicine. Wait. Dark, moody, powerful? Yes, he's perfect.
This is it.
How sad is this?
Huh?
Pains me to see it. All that power going to waste.
Who are you?
Name is Hades, Lord of the Dead, God of the Underworld, yada yada, how you doing? Hey, let me guess. You're trying to put the kibosh on the darkness inside you. Am I right? Of course I'm right. Well, anyway, bad idea.
Wait, what?
Okay, stay with me. Darkness is inside everybody. Nothing to be ashamed of. You play nice with it, and darkness will be your best friend. But if you go and get all self-conscious and refuse to face it, the darkness will run over you like a debutante at a toga sale. And then where are you? Nowhere! Now me, I look at you, and I see potential. That's right, kid. You got the potential to conquer the darkness inside you. And I'll even give you some pointers. I mean, believe me, if anybody knows conquering, I know conquering.
Well, let's hear it then. How do I conquer the darkness?
Easy. You sign up for the games. I know, I know. Please, Lord Hades, the games. But hey, you would be surprised what you can learn in the heat of battle. And don't worry, I'll be right there to guide you every step of the way. I'm kind of what you'd call an expert in the art of darkness. Oh, decide fast. This is a limited time offer.
Couple things I want to hit on. I don't remember if I said this in a previous Let's Play or possibly even earlier in this Let's Play. I don't really remember. But did you know that there was, like, we all know that there's the seven pieces apart and there's, you know, the Disney princesses, the princess line. Well, there was a villain's version of that called the Princess of Darkness at one point. I don't know. I find that entertaining. And two, I really dislike how they always, how the Hercules Disney series paints Hades as, like, evil simply because he is the god of the underworld. Hades was never evil. He's just a Chthonian god rather than an Olympian god. So, that's just a pet peeve of mine. And I find it interesting that they're like dark, brooding, and powerful. I almost feel like that's them trying to rewrite the fact that they made Cloud like so brooding in the first game, which we'll see when we get there. But I thought that's just how Cloud was, and that's really more of an Advent Children sort of thing. And I'm sorry, I don't really consider Advent Children canon at all. It was not a good movie. Let's actually check and see what my command decks look like. Ooh, all of these have been successfully completed. And let's go. And then melt command. The zero gravity. Can I meld it with anything else other than thunder? And actually, let's go to action commands and see if there's anything that can be added. Yeah, air slide. There we go. Alright, now we're ready to go.
When are you going to tell me how to conquer the darkness?
Hold your chariot horses.
You would not believe the bureaucracy involved with these things. Name?
Terra.
Kind of earthy, but all right. Now, height and weight. What's this? Favorite god? Come on, Hades. There, ba-boom. Easy peasy. I sense that you're already starting to get all warm and fuzzy with that darkness inside you. It's sweet, really. And hey, by the time you win the final match here, you'll have figured out how to conquer it for good. And don't worry, anything goes wrong, I'll make it all go away. Service with a smile.
I got it.
You know, a trope I genuinely love in media in general is that the villain having a contract. I love villains that have a contract because to me, like, it's like, oh yeah, you can deal out, you know, good deeds or whatever anytime you want. That doesn't really matter. But if you're trying to be evil or have negative intentions, there has to be a, contract for it. And then the person has to sign it in order for anything to actually, like, take effect. I don't know, I love that trope. The easier way on these things. Come on, pop up, you fucking bitch. I really hate time trials of any kind. Really, really do. Oh my god, I can't believe that worked. Seriously, how many rounds? How many fucking rounds? Button-mashy sort of character, so, I mean, you don't have to work too hard, and I am playing this on, like, the easiest difficulty level. Oh, fuck. I hate my life. Oh, one moment. Alright, sorry about that. There was something that I had to take care of. It is apparently not the best day for me to record. But it was at least this time it was more positive than the last time I was in it. Oh my god, I'm not gonna beat these things in time. Oh, damn! I'm gonna have to start from the beginning, aren't I? Retry, it's gonna put me... God damn it. Alright, you know what? I will show you. I'm just gonna cut here, and when I get back to that point where I was at before, I'll start a new video, and we'll deal with it then. So, thank you for watching, and I will see you next time.